Just some days ago, Google finally released so much anticipated Gemini model, and it beats GPT-4 on nearly each benchmark, which makes it the best LLM to date.
I've worked on AI my whole life because I've always felt would be the most beneficial and consequential technology for humanity. Human beings in our society, we have 5 senses, and the world we built and the media we consume is in those different modalities. So I'm super proud and excited to announce the launch of the Gemini era, a first step towards a truly universal AI model.
If you watch all the demos that I watched and read the paper, it's clearly the next level in LLMs. What's interesting, Google says that in future, it will be getting even more general than video and audio. Over time, Gemini will get more senses, like actions and touch. And this is definitely exciting, and we will talk about that. But at first, have you noticed that the pace of technological progress is speeding up? Several days ago, DeepMind's AI made 800 years worth of discovery. Their AI tool called Gnome has discovered 2.2 million new crystals. These new materials can power future technologies, starting from our favorite computer chips to solar panels and batteries. Now, if you look at the history of technology, if you consider anything from mobile phones to computers, there is always the same trend. At first, we built for a specific solution, like the first version of ChatGPT. And then, with time, a single more powerful solution takes over. For example, in the past, we used to have a separate device for everything. For example, a voice recorder, right? Digital camera, a GPS. But of course, now all of those things can be done by an average smartphone. The same trend is going to happen in artificial intelligence as well. In the future, it will be easier to create one large single model than to create multiple small models, just because the biggest cost is what it costs to pay human workers to develop these models. And I talked about this with the CEO of Archetype AI, exciting startup working on expanding multimodality of large language models.
Now, the question is, do we think there's going to be one human, like planet-size AI which does everything? I think that people talk about AGI. I doubtful that is going to happen. But I think they're going to be a very large models which do a one large group of functionalities. And large language models is one of them. Maybe they're going to be large vision models. What we're building is what we call large behavior models. We in the company build this new class of models, which are called LBM, large behavior model, which looks for patterns of behavior in the real world captured by a variety of sensors.
What's recently became possible that was not possible before is that we can create generic foundational models, and we can teach these models to understand multimodal input, such as audio, video, information about vibration, and also information coming from the radar, for example. And in this data, they are looking for patterns or behavior over time. And eventually, they will be able to answer any possible question. For example, they would be able to identify why an accident has happened. In general, there are 2 things that can be scaled in AI. It's search and learning. And many research papers suggest that the creativity will actually arise from search, from AI exploring a huge space of possibilities. And actually, there is one interesting example how AI discovered unconventional, creative solution through tree search. It's the famous move 37 made by AlphaGo back in 2016. And it actually became symbolic of AI's ability to innovate. But was it really creative? Let me know what you think.
If you have a limited space to choose from, what creativity means? A game of chess, a game of Go designed by humans, right? So it's fully understandable, right? the universe which we're living in, the way we map it out into the knowledge, is by definition is limiting. The universe is much more complex and much more difficult. And there's a lot of things we don't know. If we define creativity as discover patterns which we never knew about, well, I don't know the answer to these questions, but what I'm 100% certain is that it will accelerate our capabilities in discovering new things and seeing new things, 100x, 100,000x, 1,000,000x, I think. It gives a superpower, fundamentally, these models.
And now, DeepMind's AI discovered 2 million new materials, to be more specific, 2 million new crystals. To do this, they've created an AI tool called Graph Networks for Material Exploration, a tool that can discover new materials very quickly. And again, they did it using graph search. And then they synthesized some of these new materials in Berkeley Lab, where AI was guiding robots through this process. How amazing and beautiful it is. I'm a huge fan of DeepMind's work in this field because they're constantly pushing the envelope at the frontiers of science. And if you agree, please share this video so more people can learn about it. We already know that by this point in time, we can use AI tools to create something cool for ourselves. For example, build a website. And for this task, Hostinger AI Website Builder is a fantastic option. Creating a website with a Hostinger AI tool is very easy. You can actually build your website with just 4 or 5 clicks. You can either choose from 150 pre-made designer templates or generate a website from scratch using Hostinger AI Website Builder. Their AI tool constructs a website for you based on one single prompt. All you need to do is to type in your brand name and then provide a brief description of your brand or business. Based on this information, it then chooses the most appropriate website interface and what text and images to place on this website. What's more, Hostinger offers additional AI-powered tools to further enhance your website. Use the AI logo maker to create a logo, or you can leverage the AI heat map to predict areas of your site where visitors will pay the most attention. The process is very user-friendly, and you don't need any technical knowledge or background to manage it. If you've been thinking about creating a website for a long time, now it's the time. To secure an extra 10% off on all annual plans, use the link in the description below and use the coupon Anastasia10 at the checkout. Now, Google finally released Gemini, and it's essentially a combination of their famous AlphaGo and LLM. And the basic idea behind AlphaGo is that it combines deep learning and Monte Carlo tree search to play the game of Go. And Gemini's multimodal capabilities is just another level.
Traditionally, multimodal models are created by stitching together text-only, vision-only, and audio-only models in a suboptimal way at the secondary stage. Gemini is the multimodal from the ground up, so it can seamlessly have a conversation across modalities and give you the best possible response.
Gemini is our largest and most capable model. It means that Gemini can understand the world around us in the way that we do and absorb any type of input and output. So not just text like most models, but also code, audio, image, and video.
Both objects are round and flat.
There you go.
Both are food. The orange is a healthier choice than the cookie. Citrus can be calming, and so can the spin of the fidget toy. They are both examples of popular toys that have been enjoyed by children and adults alike for many years.
Gemini is based on this paper, a family of highly capable multimodal models. So they've released Gemini in 3 versions, Ultra, Pro, and Nano. Ultra is the most capable one. Nano is the one which you can run locally at edge, for example, on your phone, and Pro is their equivalent of GPT 3.5. This version is already available in BART, and soon it will be available in Search, Ads, and their other products. Honestly, the benchmarks looks rather surprising. Here are the benchmarks comparing Gemini Ultra to GPT-4. In general capabilities, it received 90%, and GPT-4 received 86.4%. If we look at math and code benchmarks, it scored higher in basic and challenging math problems, and it's much better at code generation. In total, it outperformed GPT-4 in 7 out of these 8 benchmarks. And on all multimodal benchmarks, it surpassed GPT-4, which makes Gemini definitely the best LLM to date. Just have a look at this demo.
So we were looking at this study from 2022. The authors had created a data set by reviewing tens of thousands of scientific papers in genetics. They found a few hundred papers that contained the relevant information, extracted it by hand, and collected it in a table. Studies like this can take a lot of time. We needed to update this data set with what's new over the last couple of years. But that's over 200,000 new open access papers added to this domain since 2021. We couldn't do this manually, so we asked Gemini to help us out. And over a lunch break, Gemini read 200,000 papers for us, filtered it down to 250, and extracted their data. So now we have a refreshed version of this data set. With our refreshed data set, we can now ask Gemini to update a graph from the original study. We first gave Gemini a screenshot of this figure. Then we asked it to generate the code required to plot it. And by feeding this code our new data set, we get our updated figure. You can see that this figure now includes data up until 2023.
Oh, wow. I'm deeply impressed by this. And the demos showing Gemini's video understanding capabilities are also pretty cool.
The duck is in the middle of the ocean. There is no land nearby for the duck to rest or find food. It is unlikely to find ducks here naturally. Both objects are round and flat.
There you go.
Both are food. The orange is a healthier choice than the cookie. Citrus can be calming, and so can the spin of the fidget toy. They are both examples of popular toys that have been enjoyed by children and adults alike for many years.
What's interesting, Google is already looking at combining Gemini with robotics and then adding different senses to it. And as you know, many great minds are working on bringing AI with these multimodal capabilities into physical world, which I'm truly excited about. And I think we will see this development happening very fast because the pace of AI progress is accelerating. In all of this, the most interesting question to me is, will AI models be able to discover completely new solutions? Not the combination of already existing things, which generative AI is already doing pretty well now, but completely new solutions. Because that's what we need in order to push the science, hopefully, in the right direction.
I see this model as a tool and less of the kind of some sort of AGI style, whatever, intelligence, you know. It's going to be our cognitive enhancement and cognitive amplifier, which makes humans way, so we will be able to solve problems and discover things we've never seen before and never heard about.
As you know me, I don't like to speculate. Still, many of you were messaging me and asking about the Q star and what this can potentially mean. As you know, about 1 or 2 weeks ago, Reuters were writing about the internal OpenAI Q-Star project.
There's another twist in the OpenAI saga involving a possible breakthrough in artificial intelligence. According to one of the sources, the project involved is called Q-Star, and some internally believed progress made on Q-Star could be a breakthrough in the startup's search for superintelligence, also known as artificial general intelligence.
What's interesting, in an interview with Wired some days ago, Sam Altman called it an unfortunate leak. Now, what is the Q-Star model? Many suspect that it has to do with the Q-learning, but you know, Q-learning for deep learning is nothing new. It was already described by DeepMind in this paper from 2013, which is honestly an eternity for this field. In two words, it's a goal-oriented reinforcement learning algorithm, and I talked about it before. And the star from Q star seems to come from A star search, graph search algorithm, which is so commonly used in computer science. There is a lot of excitement around this topic, and many people suspect that AGI, artificial general intelligence, is right around the corner. While I understand all of this excitement and where it's coming from, I find it really hard to believe that that's the case. So, what's next? It's quite obvious that it has been a huge acceleration of change recently, and a huge acceleration of technological progress that I do feel. You know, it has been just one year since ChatGPT was released, and by this point, it's already old news, and now we're already talking of general intelligence. I think that from this moment on, the changes will be happening only faster. What now takes years will take merely months in the future, and the rate of change we'll be experiencing in 20 years from now will be at least 4 times faster. Unbelievable. Like Ray Kurzweil said, the whole 20th century is equivalent to 20 years of progress at today's rate of progress. And because of this exponential growth, the 21st century will be equivalent to 20,000 years of progress at today's rate of progress, which is so interesting to think about. And this also makes me so happy to live at this moment. So guys, get ready for a lot of exciting innovations and also a lot of cognitive dissonance. Because honestly, I expect unexpected to happen. If you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like, subscribing to the channel, and the most important, please share it with your friends and on social media. I always see your reposts, and this makes me very happy. Thank you so much, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao.